we're now going to see an element that very often works together with animations. That's why it's in the section on animation. It's not really an animation itself. It's basically just an element that can show you two sides. Let's see what that looks like. Here we got a rectangle that is green, and now it's red. Okay, I admit, you have to apply quite a bit of imagination to see how that fits into your application, but I'm sure you have something in your application where you got a front side and a back side of whatever is going on. Now, what do the flippable bring to the table? So you saw a black window here. The flippable is this element inside it that has a front and a back. The front is green and the back is red. Both of them has the width and height of 100 by 100 pixels, and both are centered in the parent. So we have two different elements here, two different rectangles, one representing the front, the other representing the back of the flippable element. What the flippable brings to the table is that it knows what is front and what is back, and then it will display one of them. The other will be well hidden. What it do not bring to the table is animation. So that's why it's almost and not entirely fits into this section here, because you need to run your own animation for this. So the flipping animation that we had in there, you need to do that yourself. And that's what we do here in these lines. So my flippable element here has a transformation set up here, and the transformation is a rotation around the x-axis. So I got my x-axis here, so you can see that it rotates around the x-axis. I could have set up that it should rotate around the y-axis. That would have looked like this instead. Oops. And now when I click it, you can see that it's the y-axis that it rotates around. And of course, I could have done it around the z-axis. That, however, doesn't really work, as you can see. Okay, jokes aside, let's get back and rotate around our x-axis here. The rotation is not an animation on its own. The rotation is just an angle that is set up. I need to run an animation for that. And that's what I do down here. When I click my mouse area, unclicked, then I'm flipping a bit that's called flipped. So flippable.flipped is negated here. And my angle is set up to either be zero, so rotate at 0 degrees, or 180 degrees along the x-axis up here. And then there is this behavior element that we saw early on. So whenever I'm changing my flippable bit, I'm not rotating just instantly. I am over 500 milliseconds, I am updating my angle from 0 to 180 degrees, from 180 degrees back to 0. We can see that if I comment out my behavior here and run it again, you can see clicking, it is flipped instantly to the new degree, so there's lack of animation there. If you look at the documentation for Flippable, there is one thing that might trick you over, and that is when you look at that, you'll notice there is a property called site, and you'll say, I want to do an animation, I'll do that on site. But site tells you not your destination, it shows you where are you currently. Let me show that to you. To be able to, let's go to the documentation first and see the site. It's right here, it's an enumeration site, and site behind my back. It says site is an enumeration that is a flippable, flippable front, or flippable back. So let's try and see the value of our site, because that also allows us to see GammaRay one more time solving a problem for us. So let me put in a text here next to the flippable. Yes, put in text here. The text will be my flippable dot site equal to flippable dot if it's equal to front, then it should say front, otherwise it should say back. And we need to anchor it so that it's looking good. It should be bottom, should be anchored to parent.button. And if you remember, it was actually a black background, so we better change the color of our text, otherwise we'll not be able to see anything at all. Now when I run it, it was indeed the wrong place. We want it down here. Now you can see it sitting down here. So when I run it, you can see that it changes from front to back. And I challenge you, of course, you're watching this on a playback, so you can make me go really slow by just making me go with a less frames per second. And then you'll be able to see exactly when. But when you're sitting there in your own production and you need to know exactly when is it actually flipping, do you know where I'm going? Yes, Gamma Ray. And remember, we saw that a few videos ago, Gamma Ray has this facility for slowing down your animation, so enable slowdown mode. And now when I run it, you can see right there, right when I go from the front to the back, that is when my site is updating. So site tells me what site am I actually looking at now, while my flippable.flipped here was my destination, where did I want to go? Okay, that was a very short video, kind of on flippable element. Again, it's not one of those things that you want to do all the time, but when you do it, hey, why reinvent the wheel? In the next video, we're going to talk about states and transitions, which is, I don't know why it fits into this animation thing, but it does somehow, and it's about getting back to being really declarative in your programming. So until then, have a great time.